Hello everyone. In this video, we are going to discuss the topic prime factorization. So before we come to prime factorization, we should know two things. First one is prime numbers and composite numbers. So first we'll revise prime numbers and composite numbers, and then we'll move to prime factorization. So let's begin with prime numbers. The numbers which have only two factors are called prime numbers. For example, say number 3. The factor of 3 is 1 and 3. Factor means these are the only two numbers which can divide 3 exactly. Exactly means without leaving a remainder. So it has only two factors, that is 1 and 3. Let's take another example, say 11. Again, 11 also has only two factors, that is 1 and 11. So even 11 can be also divided only by 1 and 11 exactly without leaving a remainder. So such numbers are known as prime numbers, and the two factors are 1 and the number itself. So for 3 it is 1 and 3 itself, for 11 it is 1 and 11 itself. Now let's move to composite numbers. These numbers have 3 or more than 3 factors. Let's take one example. Say 6. The factors of 6 are 1, 2, 3 and 6. So 6 can be divided exactly without leaving a remainder by 1, 2, 3 and 6. So all together it has got 4, 1, 2, 3 and 4 factors. So it is a composite numbers. Let's move to another number, say 15. 1, 3, 5 and 15. So 15 also has 4 factors, 1, 3, 5 and 15. Let's move on to prime factorization. The process of representing a composite number as the product of its prime factors is known as prime factorization. Let's take one example, say 30. So first we begin with the smallest prime factor of 30. So the smallest prime factor of 30 is 2. So when we multiply 2 with 15, we get 30. So we got one prime factor over here. This is still a composite number. Now let's convert it again into prime factors. So 15 can be written as 3 into 5. Here 3 and 5 both are prime factors. So we can write 30 as 2 into 3 into 5. So it can be represented as 2 into 3 into 5. So it is the product of its prime factors. Now there are two methods of finding prime factorization. And the two methods are, the first one is division method. Now let's take one example. Let's say we have to find the prime factorization of number 84. So first, we should remember that we should always start with the smallest prime factor. So the smallest prime factor for 84 is 2. So let's divide 84 by 2. We get 42. Again for 42, the smallest prime factor is 2. So we get 21. Here we are dividing 42 by 2 and we get 21. Now the smallest factor for 21 is 3, 7. So we have to divide it until we get 1. Now 7 can be divided only by 7. So 7 ones are 7. So we get our answer this way. But remember, whenever we write prime factorization, we never use 1 or any composite number. So this will be represented as prime factorization of 84 equals to 2 into 2 into 3 into 7. 2, 2, 3 and 7. We never consider this one, and there should never be a composite number. Now let's move on to another method. Let's take one example, let's say 60. Now let's find the prime factorization of 60 by factor tree method. So the smallest factor for 60 is 2. So 2 into 30 is 60. So we already got one prime number. This is a composite number. Again, we have to convert this into prime factors. So 2 into 15 makes 30. So again we are getting one prime factor. The next one is composite number. Again we need to change this into prime factors. So we got 3 and 5. Now all these numbers are prime factors. So 60 can be represented as 2 into 2 into 3 into 5. So this is the prime factorization of 60, and here we have not used one or any of these composite numbers. So we come to the end of this video. Catch me in another video for HCF. Thank you.